2 years ago, when I was in first grade, I had just come to America. I was still adapting to the way Americans acted and the school's language, which is American. There in school, I met a lot of bullies that were really mean. And these two bullies who really got on my nerves, I don't know their names, but they were still pretty big, and I'm pretty sure they were probably in fourth or fifth grade at that time. The first time I met those bullies was when I was at the playground. They were bullying some of the friends I made, so I tried to protect them. Then I had done something really bad. The bullies just turned on me. They bullied me, teased me, and called me names. Afterward, I think that I should have stood up for myself, but at that time, I think I panicked and I think I just walked away. Second time was no better. The second time, I needed to give them a pep talk about why they were being so mean and why they forgot those lessons the teachers had told us that was really important in our lives. What the teacher said was completely broken for those two boys. They were really big, and they started bullying me almost right after I joined in for the school. That was almost 2 years ago. Now, I don't think they bully anymore, since I've never seen them around anymore. But now, I think that I should have been braver and told someone else at that day to prevent them from being bad. I know there are many other bullies in the world and many other kids like me, and I think they should actually be able to stand up for themselves. And I thought they had to stop bullying because they just got roasted by a first grader. But as usual, I was totally wrong. The last time I met them was the best. On that miraculous day, they actually stopped bullying. I had stopped bullying because while they were bullying me, I asked the teacher because I got so furious. That's when the teacher gave them a long lecture about being good and why they broke those rules the teachers had told us that was super important. So, the bullies were there, getting pep-talked, while I was just standing right next to them awkwardly while the vice principal was chewing them out. Now they're not bullying for sure, but I still don't, and I hope they stay that way, since I don't want them bullying and me calling the teacher and being standing awkwardly like that on the side while they were getting chewed out by vice principal.